Okay, hello everyone, this is Mr. Alberonen here again, and today we're going over Nejire in My Hero 1's Justice 2 Remix Edition. And Nejire, unlike some of the other characters that I've gone over, doesn't actually have that many changes. The only few changes she has are to some of her quirk buttons, and how fast they are and how they link into each other. So, the main examples of this is her quirk 2 can now actually link into her tilt quirk 2, and her tilt quirk 2 can actually be cancelled into her quirk 1. So after any hit of that, you can actually cancel it into the tilt quirk 1. You can actually even do it before she does the final blast, if that's going to meteor blow. So, yeah, those kind of change her combos in interesting ways. You can also cancel the quirk 2 into the quirk 1, but yeah, you're not going to be doing that often if you can cancel the quirk 2 into the tilt quirk 2 into the quirk 1. Because that's, even just this on its own, can be a pretty big chunk of damage. Just doing all these quirk buttons together is 7,000, and obviously, you can add that into your combos. So, those being the main changes. Oh, also a change to her quirk 2 is that it's actually a good wall splat tool now. It actually launches the opponent in the air and can wall splat, so it's really useful for that. So say if I get like a hit here, actually I might be a bit close if I do a hit there. You do need a little bit of space for her to do all that traveling, so if I realize I'm facing a wall from quite far away, then I can do it. And then go in for a wall splat combo. And then, yep, you mess up your combo like that. Yeah, I probably should have shortened a bit since I had done that wall splat extension. But anyways, as you kind of saw there, her combos are going to start looking like something like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, wait, nope. I can let another hit of the tilt attack hit. And then this is just a meterless combo, by the way. Oh, damn it. I got a lag spike or something, and it made me drop my combo. So that was a meterless combo right there, and did 11,000 damage. And it's pretty simple, like, if you just don't let the last hit of the tilt attack hit, it makes it a bit easier if I don't let all of the attacks hit, because sometimes that can happen as well, that glitch still exists. So yeah, if you just let, like, 6 of the tilt attack hits hit, and then go in for this here, while Bakugo's kind of closer to the ground. It's pretty consistent and pretty easy to hit. This is being a very bad example, because I've managed to drop it like 4 times in the in the span that I was saying that, but yeah. It's a pretty simple combo to hit, and you get pretty decent damage, just depending on how many hits of each thing you do. And obviously you can extend it a bit more, so if I want to add in a dash cancel, I can do something like this, and after this hits, and I just throw a dash cancel after the quirk 1, okay, maybe I have to end it a little bit earlier than that. And then just going for this. There we go, 12,400 damage. I imagine you could squeeze a little bit extra damage out of it, maybe get to 13,000. But I imagine that's probably about the cap of the damage that she can get with a single dash cancel. But that's pretty awesome damage, and just, like, even the fact that this regular combo that we did can do 11,000 damage, and, like, a little bit above, depending on how many hits you do. And also, side note, yeah, if you are facing at the perfect angle, a lot of the time this doesn't work, but if you're facing, like, against a wall from a distance, you can actually do the full, string, I believe. But you have to be, like, in the perfect positioning. If you're too far away, the opponent can recover. I'll just show what that looks like now. See, if you're a little bit far away, the opponent can recover. Oops. But if you are at the perfect distance, and I don't want to bother setting that up, this actually can work. And you get, obviously, extra damage. That actually missed there. But then you'd get about, like, I don't know, maybe close to 12,000 if both of those hit. And it just depends on the spacing. So, you might think that's the end of the combo segment, but she can actually still use her charged quirk 1 in her combos. And it's actually very easy to use it in combos, considering with her tilt quirk 2, you can actually charge it while it's happening and then cancel that into this. And then go in for your combos. So, that gives her a lot of combo potential, but it is kind of strange. So even just that there, I was able to convert off of the quirk 1 like that. Or just off of this random thing. So, why it's kind of weird is if I have the opponent on recovery, there is actually a weird gap in when you get the charged quirk 1 in the air. where there is a very small gap where the opponent can actually recover out of. See, I didn't even mean to dash cancel there, but when I attack as fast as I can, there's a tiny gap in between my attack and Bakugo's attack, and the AI can recover it, but I've tried a few times, and it's very weird to try and recover yourself in that instance, because the Quirk One keeps hitting at different times, and it's very strange. Even if you're holding the button, you recover differently, and a lot of people try to recover by, like, mashing the jump button. Well, what? And yeah, so with a lot of people trying to recover like that, a lot of the time they end up missing the recovery, like, frame, the window to recover from it. So a lot of the time it does end up being a legitimate combo. And even if the opponent does successfully recover from it, it does actually just end up being a recovery reset most of the time. Which, you know, we like those here anyways. That was a bit poorly timed on my half. But because this is a recovery reset, that 8,000 is going to be on top of the, like, 8,000 you do at the beginning, so it's really going to be a lot of damage. See, and then sometimes it hits them more, sometimes it hits them less. A lot of the time, when you just mash the attack button after this, it hits them, like, the second they recover, like that, and then she'll hit slightly afterwards. It seems a little bit iffy, but a lot of the time it works pretty well as a recovery reset. And, you know, because that's a recovery reset, the damage will be reset, and then you get extra damage off the end. But if the opponent doesn't manage to recover out of it successfully, then you just get to a combo. And you just get to go in for more attacks in your combo. Actually, I could probably extend that even a little bit more, because I didn't do the projectile limit, so if I do something like this... Oh, damn it, I was too slow. See, and that hit at a really weird angle there, where I probably would have been able to convert off of it. So it can be really strange, and I'm not quite... I haven't labbed it for long enough to be able to realize what makes all the differences. So the opponent doesn't recover on time. So maybe I can do something like this. And then, yeah, get my 12,600 for free, zero dash cancels, just because my opponent wasn't able to successfully recover out of it. And keep in mind that if they were able to successfully recover out of it, it works as a recovery reset 90% of the time. So it's really a win-win going for something like that. And the recovery reset, if it works successfully, and, like, you know, the opponent doesn't just guard you or anything, it actually will lead to more damage than the regular combo, and it'll probably end up being like 16,000 if you get it successfully. So, yeah, really awesome stuff. And, yeah, obviously, she also has really good combos now with her Tilt Quirk 2 if the opponent's facing the wall, because now she can actually get, you know, consistent wall splats, which isn't something she used to be able to get. And there we go. Like, that was a very simple combo, just two hits into the Quirk 2 wall splat and 10,000 damage. I imagine you could get more, especially since she was able to get so much damage from the floor. But yeah, it's pretty cool that she can get all that damage. And also, I'll just quickly re-show how much damage she can get if you do this whole situation. And the opponent, and you're in the right position where they can't recover. Nejire, this version of Nejire Race really seems like she's, like... It's really important, like, your positioning and the opponent's ability to recover in certain situations, which is kind of weird, and I've never really had that experience in My Hero 1's Justice, where, like, it's so crucial that the opponent recovers or doesn't recover for my combo to work. So I probably could have done a little bit more there, but see, that's going to be pretty decent damage anyways. But, yeah, that's basically Nejire. Another change is that her... plus Ultra can be done in the air, but it doesn't really help that much because it's still garbage and doesn't really hit at all, just like the ground version. It isn't fixed in this version of the game, so save your meter for some, you know, guard breaks or plus Ultra 2s, because she can actually get pretty beefy damage off of her plus Ultra 2. So if I do something like this... Wait, that didn't work. I don't think my projectile came out. And I don't have enough meter. Whoopsie. Okay, this should work. There we go. And this does pretty chunky damage, so yeah, I suggest instead of using your plus ultra wands and stuff, save up your meter. Yeah, instead of doing it in combos and plus ultra ones, save it up for a plus ultra 2 combo, or maybe a plus ultra 3 if you really want to. But yeah, she gets pretty beefy damage, so you can cash out big damage a lot of the time in the game. And yeah, you don't really need supports in her combos, because she can like connect everything pretty well, and like there's no point ever in doing it, like she can convert very easily off of the air as well. In the exact same way as she does before. And yeah, she can get big damage off of everything, so you kind of just want to save up for a plus ultra 2. Anyways, that's this version of Nejire in My Hero 1's Just 2 Remix Edition. I hope you enjoyed watching all the way through this video, and thank you for watching all the way through this video. I hope to see you next time. Bye!